Well, good morning, everyone. It is Tuesday, July the 3rd, 2012. I'm Robert Christian with Newstalk Live. Some of the news stories today, folks, that we're going to be talking about from Washington State, the anti-gay marriage initiative apparently is dead in Washington State as of yesterday. I actually got the news. However, the referendum 74 in Washington State does continue to live on. And this is the marriage law for same-sex couples in Washington State. And I want to know what your take on it is. Also this morning, breaking news, a report has come in that Andy Griffith, the sheriff of Mayberry, has apparently passed away at the age of 86. We're going to be talking about him and his legacy today on Newstalk. Berkeley's is not alone as far as the interest rate manipulation around the world, folks. Maybe even your bank made the list. And we're going to be talking about how that these banks actually did manipulate the interest rates that are charged for your credit card, your auto loans, etc., and how that they are using that to their favor. Can you say free money, someone, please? Wow. 1 year suspension for the grease bullies on a school bus from the Rochester News near Rochester, New York, a town called Grease. These young men decided that they were going to bully the school bus monitor, which was and is a senior citizen. She's a grandmother, but yet doing her job. She was bullied on the bus, and we're going to be finding out a little bit more about that. Fiat also raises the stake in Chrysler to 61.8% of the company, and potentially could that be good news for Chrysler? What do you think on that? A recent CNN poll, healthcare ruling changes the views of the Supreme Court, and what people are actually saying about Obamacare in a CNN poll. We're going to be talking about the poll numbers. A new Hong Kong leader is chased out of a town hall meeting in Hong Kong. We're going to be talking about that story as well. Folks, look, you know, we cover a lot of things on Newstalk Live, Monday through Friday. And I take great pride to be able to present news, to be able to present the articles with a bit of inspiration and a bit of finesse, but also with a bit of a challenge. So if you like to be challenged in the news, tune in to Newstalk Live. That's what we do. Wow. Can congressional Republicans repeal Obamacare? Again, we're going to be talking about this as well. And the IMF is urging lawmakers to do more to boost the U.S. recovery. And that's sort of a first, wouldn't you say? Also, political tensions after the Mexican presidential vote in Mexico, and we are also going to be talking about that as well. Folks, Newstalk Live, we go live Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. Pacific, that's 12 noon Central, 1 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time for those that are in London, and 7 a.m. for those in Honolulu, Hawaii. And you can find us at livestream.com/Newstalk, or you can visit us on the web at our forum, that is H-O-U-R, forum, F-O-R-U-M, .net, and click on the cablecast page. And there you'll be able to see Newstalk live right there, by the power of the Internet. Isn't that kind of neat? You can also find us on Twitter at Newstalk2, and on Skype. You can add us to your Skype at Newstalk2. So, folks, there is an awful lot, folks, today for a Tuesday, which is sort of, I can't say it's bizarre, I welcome it, but Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays typically are low-key days, well, except for today, so I guess I've got to take that back. Hey, here we are on July the 3rd, folks, July 4th is tomorrow. What are your plans for July 4th for Independence Day, and what do you declare as being independent, and from who? So, folks, we've got that and more today on Newstalk Live, so do join us, won't you, beginning at the top of the hour at 10 a.m. at Newstalk Live. And don't forget, folks, on the 4th, we have a special presentation that we are actually going to be airing at 10 right here on Newstalk Live. So, folks, I will see you at the top of the hour, and I hope to see you soon. So, do subscribe to our YouTube channel, folks. That's what I do it for. I put the news up here on the YouTube channel, so or at least parts of the news. That way, everybody can get a good idea as to what's going on, because there's always more than what meets the eye. So, folks, I will see you at the top of the hour. Again, good day, folks, and I'll see you soon.